The problems, the weather. It's been too rough to connect the hose. It takes the oil off the Rena and over to the Aranuia. With 30 knot winds and up to 4 meter swells, work stopped late last night and everyone left. The Rena became a ghost ship once again. And like every ghost story, well, it's scary.
And that's right, $1 million from the Mediterranean Shipping Company for an operation which has already cost more than $4 million and is likely to get much more expensive than that. When it does, MSC says it will not contribute anymore. They're not liable for the cost. They don't own the ship, nor do they employ the crew, but they were hiring Rena when it hit the Astrolab Reef. And Mediterranean Shipping Company says they're corporates with a conscience, and that's why they've donated $1 million to the cleanup effort.
So given that you're not liable and you don't see yourselves as responsible, why have you offered this money at all?
Just to help the people of Tauranga. We have an office here. We have staff here.
It's the largest shipping line in the world in terms of container vessel capacity. The Rena is one of 457 container vessels that the company uses.
The oil is New Zealand's largest oil spill. There's significant pressure on the people of the Bay of Plenty. And we are trying to show a gesture. We're an international shipping company. We wish to continue trading here. We have been here for 15 years.
So what did the people of Tauranga think of the donation?
They're making enough out of the New Zealand economy. They should be footing the bill for the whole lot.
88 of MSC's containers have fallen off the Rena and many have washed up on shore. MSC says their donation isn't an admission of liability because that rests with the owners of the vessel, Costamari Incorporated. But Transport Minister Stephen Joyce says however MSC sees their position, he still believes the shipping giant has a role to play, and a financial role at that. This is a start.
This is a start.
We think that's a significant donation. And we hope that the people of the Bay of Plenty appreciate that.
There's a start, there's a start, there's a start.
This is a start.
There's a start.
$30 million.
Nature seems determined to take the Rena to the depths. 4 meter swells are pounding the wreck, but the split ship remains on the reef. The bow still stuck fast, the stern still attached somehow.
She is being held together both by the reef and by internal structures.
It has escaped from Rena's punctured hull, but the swells have pushed it out to sea and broken it up. No more has made it to the beaches, which authorities say are 90% clean. Salvors are waiting for a break in the weather before going back on board, as long as the Rena holds together.
If the two sections do detach, an attempt will be made using the tugs that are out there to tow the stern section back around either onto the reef or around into shallow water.
They won't reveal where the broken stern would be towed, but it needs to be less than 50 metres deep if divers hope to salvage anything. Not a popular option, but it will be the ocean that decides if it's needed.
Covered remains of a container washed ashore at Pekaha, and another's been reported at Lawton Point, just east of Te Araroa on the East Cape. Kim Benell reports.
These are the men charged with one of the most difficult salvage operations in the world. Lowered slowly onto Rena as she's battered by 4 metre swells and 50 kilometre an hour winds. A dangerous walk navigating a ship still on a 21 degree lean. But they're still unable to restart pumping fuel off. Next mission is to enter Rena's damaged right side for the first time. Until then, authorities won't be drawn on how close the ship is to splitting in two.
The ship's not in the same condition it was 10 days ago or 5 days ago. So the salvers had to work with what they've got.
We took to the air to see for ourselves what the wind and waves have done to the vessel, catching this chopper mid-task, dropping crucial equipment to salvage workers on board. As we headed back to shore, the Awanuia that had been sheltering behind Motiti Island made its way back to Rena, but she won't be used until morning.
The starboard side, the low side of the Rena, is currently exposed to both a combination of the wind and the wave action. It's also creating a number of reflected waves that are hitting the side of the ship and bouncing back out, which is one of the reasons that the Awanuia cannot get alongside today.
It's a crane ship, which could be employed to remove containers. But saving the vessel is the last piece of the puzzle. Pumping fuel off, however long that takes, comes first.